Namaste to all my viewers. We all know that nobody has ever become poor by giving. In fact, it gives joy, happiness, and satisfaction to the core. You can find your own novel ways to get that soul satisfaction. One of the ways can be donating your blood or plasma. We all know Raktadan is called Mahadan. So we at DAV Centenary Public School have been religiously organizing blood donation camps in our premises annually since almost 2 decades. Many of you may have also went and donated your blood or plasma at some point or the other, whereas a few of you may have been having your own excuses for not doing so. Or maybe you have some unanswered questions in your mind that are prohibiting you from doing it. Well, I'm here today to dispel all myths and misconceptions about blood and plasma donation. I have usually seen people asking, how do I know if I have any spare blood to donate or not? Well, I must tell you that your body is constantly manufacturing blood. So there is no need to be concerned about extra reserves. In fact, you can donate again after 56 days, that is 8 weeks or 3 months in case of whole blood. And in case of platelets, they can be donated every 2 weeks up to 24 times per year, and plasma can be donated after every 4 weeks. Some of the patients also asked me, I'm afraid I might be rejected. Yes, you may be rejected if your hemoglobin is lower than 12.5 if you are a female, or less than 13 if you are a male. Many health conditions also fall under a deferral criteria for blood donation. You may inquire about the general eligibility criteria before you go ahead with the donation. It differs for whole blood as well as convalescent plasma. People are also afraid that they will feel weak after donation. My dear friends, you must know that donors are served adequate refreshments that replenish some of the sugar and liquids in the body that doesn't let you feel weak after donation. Oftentimes, fear of needles is what prevents people from going ahead with donation. Friends, you can always turn an adversity into opportunity. So if you are afraid of needles, go ahead with the donation. It may help you overcome the fear of needle. And the most frivolous of all the excuses that I've ever heard is, I'm too busy. Just imagine, how would you feel if you or your loved one needs it and you hear such an excuse? Remember, a single donation can actually help as many as 3 different people. Now, in what other activity can so little time you do so much? And last but not the least, I have seen people saying, Baki log kar to rahe hain, hame kya karna hai? I must tell you, the supply-demand change is imbalance. Blood centers nationwide typically run into blood shortages at various times throughout the year. So my sincere request to all of you, please, please donate your blood whenever possible. Of course, only if you are fit and you are okay for the eligibility. And if you have already recovered from COVID-19 and have been symptom free for 14 days or more, or have a confirmed positive COVID-19 antibody test, which is normally so between 28 to 40 days after illness, please donate your plasma. Remember, plasma donation can save at least one plasma donation can save at least 2 lives. Now, the biggest challenge is one doesn't know where and how to do it. Project Step 1, an NGO along with the Government of National Capital Territory of Delhi, is doing a wonderful job here. You just need to dial their helpline number 1800 111 747 or 011 611 93786 and leave the rest to them. Volunteers at this organization will guide you through the process right from telling you if you are eligible for it or not and the do's and don'ts before the donation to ensure that you get to ILBS safely. Here I must tell you, ILBS Delhi is India's first plasma donation center, a Delhi government initiative to deal with the COVID-19 epidemic. I too am a proud volunteer with Step One, which is working in tandem with various state governments such as Delhi, Punjab, Goa, Maharashtra, Assam and Karnataka, and lending its helping hand to them in these trying times of COVID-19. I'm sure my talk must have sparkled the fire of helping the humanity now. Don't let it die down. Take a call now. Thank you.